Hi, I'm Torben Janssen from thoughtsonjava.org with a new Hibernate tip. JPA and Hibernate allow you to map associations in many different ways. And today I want to show you how to map a bidirectional many-to-one association. You need to model the association on both entities if you want to be able to navigate it in both directions. Consider this example. A book in an online bookstore can have multiple reviews. In your domain model, the book entity has a one-to-many association to the review entity. And the review entity has a many-to-one relationship to the book entity. Let's begin with the review entity, which is the owning side of the association in this example. That means that it defines the association and the book entity just references it. The relationship consists of two mandatory and one optional part. The entity attribute of type book and the many-to-one annotation are required. The attribute models the association and the annotation declares the type of the relationship. The join column annotation is optional. It allows you to define the name of the foreign key column. I use it here to set the column name to FKBook. If you don't define the name yourself, Hibernate generates a name by combining the name of the association mapping attribute and the name of the primary key attribute of the associated entity. In this example, Hibernate would use book underscore ID as the default column name. You also need to map the one-to-many association on the book entity to make it bidirectional. As you can see here, this is done in a similar way as the many-to-one association. You need an attribute that models the association, which is the list reviews attribute in this example. And you need a one-to-many annotation. Like in the table model, the bidirectional one-to-many association gets defined on the many side. The table on the many side stores the foreign key, and its entity defines the association. It's similar for the entity mapping. You just need to reference the name of the association attribute of the many side as the value of the mapped by attribute, and Hibernate has all the information it needs. That's all you need to do to define a bidirectional many-to-one association. You can now navigate it in both directions in your JPQL or Criteria API queries or on your domain objects. Bidirectional associations are easy to use in queries, but they also require an additional step when you persist a new entity. You need to update the association on both sides when you add or remove an entity. You can see an example of it here. I first create a new review entity and initialize its association to the book entity. And after that, I also need to add the new review entity to the list of reviews on the book entity. Updating the associations on both entities is an error-prone task. Therefore, it's a good practice to provide a helper method that adds another entity to the many side of the association. Okay, that's it for today. If you want to learn more about Hibernate, you should join the free Thoughts on Java library. It gives you free access to a lot of member-only content, like an ebook about the Java 8 support in Hibernate, a printable PDF version of this Hibernate tip, lots of cheat sheets, and a video course. I'll add the link to it to the video description below. See you next week for a new Hibernate tip, and if you liked today's video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe below. Bye!